So now let's talk about your probes. You have a set of four probes that come with the ACTIVet system. So let's talk about which one to use and why and when. Well, the easiest one to refer to is the wound probe. And this just, they all thread right onto the front very easily. And this comes in handy when you're working on a wound where you don't want to disturb that tissue bed. You want to reduce contamination issues to a minimum. And so this is a wonderful smooth way. And also when you're treating arthritis, you just want to, you know, get some extra ease of motion in here, reducing the friction. This large wound probe is wonderful for that. Or I call it a dome probe in that case. And then for wounds, you're just hovering over the surface about a half inch. And you're not worried about penetration through skin, of course, because with a wound, you don't have any skin barrier. You've got open exposed flesh. So just a hover over the surface. I'll turn it on here and show you. And you're just hovering over the surface of that wound. And you can see up here, that's our dome probe. And it also kick in that blue. Anytime you have a break in the skin, with horses, it's a fungal issue, with your dogs, cats, anytime you have a break in the skin, you want to prevent the possibility of infection or certainly mitigate against it or help reduce infection and fight infection faster, kick in that blue. 470 nanometers is a wonderful frequency for that, a wonderful wavelength, I should say. So just hover over the surface. That's the dome probe. The next is our acupuncture probe, or it's referred to as auricular probe. Threads on just the same way. And our acupuncturists, some like to use this sharper tip, and what you're doing is it's a waveguide. It takes all that energy to one specific point. So you're just placing that without a lot of pressure at all, just placing it on that acupuncture point, and typically about 15 seconds is all it requires to give you that nice reaction, that nice fundamental profound response. So very easy to use that as well. That's the auricular probe. For acupuncture, many of our practitioners prefer to use this corporal probe because it's not quite as sharp. It's a little bit more blunt. It's long, but it's not quite as sharp on the end, and so it's easier to place it against an animal and not have a response from that of it being sharper than this one. So same principle applies. You're just turning it on and 15 seconds per point. Plenty of energy along that meridian or that neural pathway, whichever your preference, to give you that profound response that you're looking for with laser instead of needles. And many of you vets have reported to us that it can get pretty tricky going down the leg of a cat. And with this, there's just no penetration of the skin. And they find it very, very preferable. It's much more relaxing for them. And it can be much faster as well. So this is the corporal probe, also very good for acupuncture. The next probe, this is my favorite when I'm working on an ear or lacerations in the corner of a mouth or stomatitis cases. So otitis, stomatitis, this is a wonderful probe for that. And again, because it's taking the energy as a waveguide and taking it to a specific point. And that's wonderful for working inside these large ears, especially on a basset hound. You know, when these ears get really badly infected and crusty and nasty, and you don't want to have to pull that ear back and bend it because it's so sensitive. You can just apply this probe inside and take that energy. When there's infection, remember, always use that blue, the 470 nanometer blue, to reach into that ear and work all those areas with infection. You're going to use the 50 hertz, of course, to pull down that inflammation, the blue to fight the infection, and this is just incredibly effective for that. Now, with cats with stomatitis issues, you can treat through through the cheek initially, because the energy will go through that cheek tissue, it's nice and thin, to get into those stomatitis cases with your feral cats. And then once they're acclimated to the laser, you can start using this probe, and then you're able to just open the mouth and apply this right along the gum lines where that ulceration is occurring. In greyhounds that are particularly prone to your gingivitis issues, it's great to disrupt this right along the gums. Now, I know there was one case working on a hippopotamus, and I was very glad to have my hand outside of its mouth. This probe gave me great standoff capability. I can work on the gums and not have my hand inside its mouth. So these are wonderful for accessing ears, stomatitis cases. You'll find lots of applications for this. This is another wonderful probe in the set of four that comes with your ACTIVet, and you can see each of those up in the graphic behind me.